Hi, this is Kate from MinuteEarth. Earth's ocean water, all 140 million-ish square miles of it, is all interconnected, which becomes really clear when you look at the world like this. Technically, our planet only has one ocean, the giant, not so creatively named, World Ocean. But that makes it hard to talk about different parts of the ocean on different parts of the planet. It makes sense to split it up, but how do you divide a continuous body of water? Since we humans have a habit of making things all about us, historically we have divvied up all that water based on our own perceptions. For example, centuries ago, Western seafaring routes clustered in certain areas, like between Europe and North America, and Western Africa and South America. As a result, we thought about these areas as separate oceans. But the problem with dividing up water based on our worldview is that our worldview is, well, fluid. As our routes diversified and our horizons widened, we began to recognize just a single Atlantic. The same thing happened elsewhere in the world, and we ended up with four big blobby oceans, outlined mostly by land. To deal with parts that aren't outlined by land, we, well, specifically map makers and government organizations, who like things cut and dried, took the sticky, outiest bits of land and extended lines straight out from them. Boom! Problem solved. We now have clearly defined oceans. But here's the thing. The bit of water at the very edge of, say, the Indian Ocean is no different than the bit of the Pacific Ocean just next to it. In fact, those two bits of water are more similar to each other than they are to other bits of water in their own respective oceans. So while these boundaries may be clear and convenient, they don't really say much of anything about the oceans themselves, which seems kind of important. Maybe we should use what we actually know about oceans to divide them. If we look at, say, their saltiness, or the currents that drive the top layer of water, ye olde division into two Atlantics actually makes sense. But if we consider geology, underwater ridges actually cleave the Atlantic into east and west, and sea surface temperatures suggest we throw out the continents as boundaries altogether. So even science doesn't seem to have a clear answer on ocean divvying, except in one case, the water surrounding Antarctica. Ringed by a strong east-flowing current and a convergence zone where frigid polar water collides with warmer, saltier water from the north, the so-called Southern Ocean is different in pretty much every way from the water that is essentially right next to it. And while it isn't officially deemed an ocean by the world's ocean-deeming body, it seems like the only bit of the world ocean that we can actually justify separating out. All those other divisions just don't seem to hold water. Okay, so dividing up the oceans in a way that's both intuitive and helpful is clearly kind of a problem. Problems like this can be complex and daunting, so where do we even start? If you'd like to learn how to tackle complex problems in a way that's accessible and fun, then you'll like Brilliant. Brilliant is a problem-solving website and app with a hands-on approach with over 60 interactive courses in science, computer science, and math. Computer science is especially good for tackling big problems, and Brilliant's got a great new course that will have you programming a drone within minutes, even if you don't know how to code. To get hands-on today, go to brilliant.org/MinuteEarth and sign up for free. As a bonus for MinuteEarth viewers, the first 200 people that go to that link will get 20% off the annual premium subscription. That's brilliant.org/MinuteEarth.